Don't kill the cat! Ha! The random topic is, does mineral water break up kidney stones? Kidney stones, symptoms and causes, how to prevent kidney stones. Effect of mineral water containing calcium and magnesium. They're implying that you get stones drinking too much mineral water. Drinking sparkling water may be a deterrent. A thing that is intended to discourage someone from doing something. Kidney stones, trying to pass out a urinary stone can be very painful, and some people undergo the agony not once but multiple times. Patients with a recurring condition are advised to drink more water and watch what they eat. I think the uric acid, which I think is usually caused by a high concentration of sodium in the blood, it's produced more as a result of that. Obviously, contaminants and remains of whatever that isn't able to get filtered by the kidneys. Urine that has become too concentrated allows waste chemicals to crystallize and urinary stones to form. As many people find it hard to make dietary changes, Dr. Palaniappan Sundaram, associate consultant urologist, members, has been researching if simply drinking water with a certain mix of minerals will make a difference. Results after drinking sparkling mineral water for 1 week. Samples were collected before and after and analyzed for changes. It doesn't say how many. The results were generally positive. Participants, on average, produced a significant increase in urine volume, obviously because you're drinking a little bit more water. They're incentivized to drink water from 1.5 liters to 1.8 liters, meaning the participants had drunk substantial volumes of water. Oh, that's urine. So yeah, some of the water is absorbed and used up in the body and expelled through other means. A decrease in urinary oxalate secretion of 0.23 millimoles a day from 0.32 millimoles a day, and a significant increase in urinary magnesium, which means that, let's just look up oxalate first. Oxalate acid anion formula C2O42. It occurs naturally, including some foods. Variety of salts. Sodium oxalate. Urine taking more water, diluting the salts within the urine, and taking more minerals. Urinary calcium didn't increase by high calcium content in the mineral water. Urinary citrate, however, showed a slight decrease. Larger randomized control study is being planned. Give me real results. Effect of mineral water containing calcium and magnesium on calcium oxalate urolithiasis risk factors. Calcium oxalate kidney stone formers are invariably advised to increase their fluid intake so that you could dilute the concentration and release it gradually. In addition, magnesium therapy is often administered. So these are studies. This is good. Several risk factors were favorably altered by the mineral water and tap water regimens, but the former was more effective. So mineral water is beneficial to people with kidney issues. But the question was, does mineral water break up the kidney stones? It might be a misinterpretation. To the contrary, tap water produced an unfavorable change in the magnesium excretion. The group which benefited most were male stone formers, in whom 9 risk factors were favorably altered by the mineral water protocol. It is concluded that the mineral water containing calcium and magnesium, such as that used in the study, deserves to be considered as a possible therapeutic or prophylactic agent in calcium oxalate kidney stone disease. What kind of mineral water? A French mineral water containing calcium and magnesium. Maybe the calcium somehow binds to the oxalate anions. Common misunderstandings. Hard water and kidney stones. Doesn't look like a study. Many people seem to think that hard water can cause kidney stones, but is it possible drinking hard water could cause some health concerns? Click here to find out more. The claim among many, we already saw it in a study, it's not just a claim. They believe. Well, maybe they just believe it because it's backed by science. Causes kidney stones. That extra calcium in hard water clumps up and hardens into solid stones. Does oxalate have anything to do with calcium? Solid piece of material. Sharp and severe pain. It's a centimeter, almost a centimeter. And wow, it's huge. High urine calcium levels. Risk factors include. This is not a belief. There are sources. Medical management of renal stones. It's a book. Obesity, certain foods, some medications, calcium supplements, hyperthyroidism, gout, and not drinking enough fluids. Stones form in the kidney when minerals in urine, doesn't say what kind of minerals, are at high concentration. Calcium oxalate. So calcium binds to oxalate radicals, free radicals. Calcium binds to oxalate radicals, diminishes the concentration. Sounds reasonable, but is it true? We just read it in like 5 different places that have actual science behind them. The answer is complicated and requires a deeper dive into hard water. Pun intended. And how the human body reacts. What is hard water? With dissolved calcium and magnesium above tolerable levels. You're already using a word that implies that it is intolerable. Long story short, drinking hard water leads to drinking inorganic calcium and magnesium that was once in the ground. Brave is probably hiding a lot of ads, especially in the speed reader view. This article apparently uses the shock factor to draw in viewers. Hard water might not directly cause kidney stones, but it is still a concern for many women because of the damage. Plumbing. Yes, your internal bodily plumbing. Alkaline water and kidney stones, the solution. 20% increase from 2019. I think that this is generally due to tap water just gradually degrading in quality. I remember we used to drink so much tap water here, but for so many years now, the flavor is awful and contains so much calcium, but it's the chlorine that gives it such an awful. Calcium hypochlorite is commonly used to sanitize public swimming pools and disinfect drinking water. Generally, the commercial substances are sold with purity, blah, 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 blah. Doesn't say the percentage that's used though. Sodium hypochlorite bleach is usually preferred due to calcium residue making the water harder. Bleach is usually preferred. They put a little bit of bleach in our water, of course. Let's just drink some bleach. That seems like a sane thing to do. And solution, calcium hypochlorite could be used as a general purpose sanitizer. They use this in the drinking water system and it makes it taste really bad, and I'm not sure what it does for health either. Sounds like if it has so much calcium in it, potentially helps with the formation of kidney stones. Alkaline water carries many largely false health claims, ranging from improving digestion and reducing cancer risk. Of course, these are all the theorists, let's not call them conspiracies. Anti-aging properties, immune boosting, colon cleaning, and yes, the prevention of kidney stones. Oh, they're implying that this is just used as marketing. But I think that generally, because it's alkaline, it has lower acidity. We all know that vegetables are beneficial for the body. Obviously, we know that fruits are also good for you. That's common knowledge. I don't think it's a lie that someone tried to come up with to boost vegetable sales or to try to force kids to eat nasty, bad tasting or tasteless foods. Because, you know, eat your veggies. It's obviously because it has health benefits. And one of them is the alkalinity, which is higher pH, which means that it's more basic, which counteracts acids. And we all know that higher acidity within the human body creates an appropriate foundation for many diseases, bacterial and whatnot, and virus and cancers to form. It doesn't mean that if you're drinking alkaline water or bottled water, mineral water, you're gonna reduce your cancer risk, but it does mean that you're creating a less appropriate environment for these diseases to form within your body. And obviously, by association, it counteracts cancers. Benefits of acid, but fruit and I don't know if vegetables are acidic, but fruit acids are beneficial as far as I know, because natural acidic foods induce the body to produce a more alkaline environment within the body. But artificial acidity in things like soda and desserts, as opposed to candy and desserts that raise acidity or lower pH in the body. Is acid even a bad thing for kidney stones in the first place? It can be. Too much acid in your urine makes uric acid, calcium oxalate, and cystin kidney stones more likely. Oh, they have references as well. That's good. It's not just random blower. By far, calcium oxalate kidney stones are the most common type of kidney stone. Uric acid kidney stones are common as well. I've heard that as well. But maybe the acidic environment helps calcium oxalate stones form as well. I gotta ask my friends with medical backgrounds. If you have a history of these types of kidney stones or have a low urine pH on a 24-hour urine test.
However, too little acid or a high urine pH makes calcium phosphate stones more likely to form.
If you drink a ton of alkaline water, You raise your stomach pH. Obviously, this is bad for your stomach as well, creating an environment that's too alkaline for your stomach. Your stomach won't be able to process foods because stomach acids are what breaks down food. If the environment within the stomach is too alkaline, it'll dilute, neutralize the acids, absorption of food and specific nutrients, especially vitamin B12 and protein. Stomach acid also helps kill harmful bacteria that might be on your food. This helps keep us safe from foodborne illness. Do we need alkaline water? Use this message to sell alkaline water. Acidity and alkalinity do play an important role in your health. Your body regulates the pH of your blood. If your blood pH gets too high or too low, your body will not be able to function properly. In fact, if your body is too alkaline, this could cause death. We know that you need electrolytes. That's why they have these energy drinks with electrolytes, which are basically probably just types of salts within them. And they help return your pH, I guess. Maybe I should look that up as well. Later, kidneys, the acid balancing powerhouse. Firstly, assuming you have working kidneys and lungs, your body is really good at keeping pH in the right range.